Is it weird that I stand in the shower and drink coffee? Sure. Barely awake. Fuck, it's 4:30 p.m. I can't get on a regular schedule. My shit is all messed up. I'm like this right here. I don't know what else to tell you. I didn't wake up at 4:30 though. I've been awake for like 30 minutes. I'm not gonna lie. Because I've been working on a vlog already. See?
Proof. Proof of the shit.
Yo, take a shower before you start vlogging. But you know, I want to be honest. I need to let the ladies know what it's like when I first wake up, you know? Let's just get in the shower real quick. Check it out. Oh, shit. Yeah, sure. Is it weird that I stand in the shower and drink coffee? Sure. But you know what the good news is? It's my shower. And it's my damn coffee. And I can do what I want. You know what I'm saying? Watch me trip and fall. Yo, so I just uploaded the vlog, and one of the first comments was, did you win? I don't know, somehow I managed to, I don't think I recorded it, so I never said it into the camera, that's why I forgot, because usually I say the result of the session in the camera. So anyway, last night at Red Rock, plus $63. That's probably why I forgot, just because it was kind of inconsequential. Yo, it's time to get out of here and go to the strip and play poker Saturday night, 7:23 p.m. Let's go. All right, vlog is uploaded. Ate food, had coffee already. What am I forgetting? Oh shit, got it. Again, with the not leaving the apartment until after dark, I gotta adjust my shit. But you know what else I gotta say about it? Fuck, fuck,
fuck the shit.
You know, it's funny, people still ask me, Trooper, why do you park away from where you play? Like, why do you play at a different place where you park? It's a valid question, but I've answered it like 37,000 times. The real number one reason is just to go out and be on the strip so that the vlog will be more interesting and more attractive. Because what good is it for me to just like park in Planet Hollywood parking garage and then go right into the poker room? It will be a little bit boring. The second reason is just that sometimes I move about. So if I play at Bally's, I might decide to go play more at Bellagio or something. Are you serious right now behind me right now? All right, here's the play. I'm gonna look at Bally's poker room. They have four games, but I wanna look at it. Then we're gonna hit Starbucks no matter what. Then I'm gonna make a decision. My original plan was to go play at Bellagio. So let's, we'll figure it out. So here's what happened. I walk by the Bally's poker room, they have four games. I only see like two, maybe three regulars in the entire room. And three tables all had one seat, one's full. So I don't know, I just had a feeling that I should grab the seat on table one because it looks like the easiest table. So I just grabbed the seat already. The chips are there and I'm gonna go grab a coffee and get started. It's funny because I just talked about the fact that I usually don't park and play at the same place. Then I explained to you why. And now I park at Bally's, I'm gonna play at Bally's. Ironic. And when I say ironic, I don't mean that it's made of iron. I mean that it is of irony. Did anybody think that I meant that it was made out of iron? No? Okay, good.
like wrought iron. Like I could go for like a wrought iron table. Maybe I need like a wrought iron love seat for my balcony. What? Except with a cushion on it though. Well, talk about tangent right there. I'm sure we'll get out here to the strip and wander around at some point tonight, but for now, I'm gonna get an iced coffee and get right into the game. Yeah, that shit's fucking loud. It always is. I'm gonna get an iced coffee and get right into the game. You know? I mean, nah, you really do know, because like, first of all, you probably know, but then second of all, I just told you. Just up to take a little break from the table. I'm winning about 375 at the moment. The game has been not like super action packed, but just super easy to read. But I just decided to walk out the old side door here onto Flamingo and give you an update. My table's a little too friendly. Seats 1, 2, and 3 know the vlogs. Shouts out to those guys. Oh my goodness, I don't like to use terms like this, but fucking gross. I just lost a $900 pot. I flopped a set of sevens, and the guy flopped a set of aces. We got it all in on the turn. Oh well. Since then though, I've come back. I'm still winning like 175 or something at the moment. Fuck me, man. In the morning, and I know what you're thinking, Trooper, what you doing in front of Paris out on the strip? I just decided to take a short walk before I got in the car to drive home. Poker is done for the night. I won $92. Oh my gosh, set over set for a $900 pot. Kind of brutal. The guy who had the set of aces was, couldn't understand half of what he was saying. He was sitting right next to me and he was getting more and more drunk. And it seemed like the drunker he got, the more he stuttered. It was a limp pot. So he didn't raise pre-flop or anything. I mean, if we're gonna play poker, at some point, we're gonna have set over set on the flop against us. And almost always, not every time, but most of the time you're just gonna go broke, or you're at least gonna get it in. And there's no reason complaining about it or being, down about it or whatever, because it's just gonna happen. I saw comments the other day that someone was saying something about, my optimistic attitude after losing or whatever. I mean, that's the whole thing. It's like, if I make some sort of horrible mistake and like just a terrible play, or I play terribly all night and I lose money, there's something to be upset about. But if I get set over set against me and I lose a, you know, monster pot because of it, there's no reason for me to be upset. He just got super lucky for me to, you know, flop a set at the same time that he flops a set. So yeah, what are you gonna do? That's the end of the night though. You know, it's 3 a.m. Super exhausted. I really wanted to stop by the store and get eggs because I'm out. But I don't think I'm going to. If you haven't noticed, I love eggs. I do. I love them. Little baby chicken abortions. I really think I should eat them raw, though. I don't think I should be cooking them. But there's always, you know, worry about bacteria and whatnot. Plus, I think they would probably taste disgusting to me. I don't know, maybe after a few times I'll get used to it, acquire a taste for it. For the moment, I'm gonna stick with over medium. That's my favorite way to have them. All right, I made it home alive. That is the end of the night. It's 4:10 in the morning. If you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe, tell your friends about the videos, and leave a comment below. I'll see you next time.